So got Richard Mille, you know what I'm saying? It's a grown man watch.
You've heard the name in songs from Drake,
Richard Mille, RM69,
Post Malone,
RM12,
Chris Brown, and Jay-Z, while also seeing them on the wrists of OBJ, Neymar, Rafael Nadal, and Pharrell. Richard Mille is rapidly climbing the ranks as one of the hottest watch brands in the past half decade. Behind the Hype, Richard Mille. If you do a simple Google search of Richard Mille today, you can see price tags of $179,000, $250,000, and $300,000. The lowest price tag we can find at the moment is $79,000. Even browsing the Richard Mille website, you can often forget you're shopping for a watch and confuse it for a sports car. Within the spotlight and fame, Richard Mille watches have been a highly priced accessory amongst notable faces. NFL star Odell Beckham Jr. faced controversy.
Well, if they're citing the rule prohibiting hard objects and this violates that, then they could keep him off the field.
Wearing a $350,000 RM1103 during a season opener, as well as a $2 million RM5601 during field warmups the following week. Pusha T even posted on Instagram, quoting, "When you realize your 70K Rolex doesn't belong in the same picture as Pharrell's Richard Mille." Pharrell actually considers Richard Mille the timepiece supreme creator and first shouted out the brand in his 2006 song, Can I Have It Like That? She know the time, she sees the Richard Mille, flat double skeleton. In addition, in 2019, Pharrell became a collaborator with Richard Mille, releasing a watch at the price point of $969,000, with only 30 of these watches being made. Frank Ocean, Drake, the Migos, the list of A-list names can go on regarding who is sporting this unique watch. But behind the obsession of Richard Mille watches is its rich history and design. The luxury watchmaking brand was founded in 2001 by Dominique Guinet and Richard Mille, along with a partnership with Swiss watchmaking manufacturer Audemars Piguet. While the brand was first registered that same year, research and development started 3 years earlier in 1998. Richard Mille's first watch, the RM001 Thorbian, officially launched in 2001 at Baselworld International Trade Show for watches and jewelry. The RM001 encompassed a lot of the brand's hallmarks we see today, a tonneau-shaped case, spline screws, a visible complex movement, extremely limited quantity, and a massive wrist presence. From 2001 onward, it was full steam ahead, evolving the RM001 into a number of other variations, each one crazier than the first. Regardless of the change in movement, material, and even shape, Richard Mille's brand identity has stayed the same. Its quest to push the limits in the horological community cannot be denied. Richard Mille's are intended to be sports watches, containing a high level of shock resistance and extremely strong and lightweight materials like grade 5 titanium, toughened ceramic, carbon thin ply technology, and graphene. Within the mid-2000s, the watches were starting to get crazy and elaborate. Fortunately enough, Richard Mille had the right partners to expand its development facilities, and in 2007, Audemars Piguet took out a supposed 10% stake in the company. That same year, Richard Mille would soon join the Fondation de la Haute Horlogerie. For the next few years, Richard Mille would put that investment to good use, producing some of the world's most groundbreaking and creative watches on the market, all the while positioning its brand with some of the biggest celebrities and professional athletes. A perfect example of this came in 2010 when Richard Mille created the RM027 Thorbian for tennis star Rafael Nadal. This was the world's lightest mechanical watch at the time and was watches have to be heavy and made from precious metals. Instead, they opt for the lightest watch with the highest level of technology. Thus, the creation of a highly engineered timepiece. And it's this formula that has brought in a loyal fan base. Richard Mille attracts both watch collectors and high rollers alike, captivated by the high-tech design and exclusivity of the watches. Behind the Hype, Richard Mille.